and Congressman Turner. A fine congressman, great reputation, too, in the House.
Well, thank you, Mr. Aiken. I appreciate your leadership in this and your leadership on the Armed Services Committee. And I want to thank you for doing this evening. This is such an important issue. And Congressman Franks, I appreciate his leadership in trying to highlight, you know, where we've been, what we've accomplished, and, of course, what threats that we have in front of us. You know, many people are not necessarily aware that we have missile defense currently deployed to protect portions of the United States and to respond to some of the threats. It's not a complete shield for the area, and it's certainly something that we moved quickly to deploy in the face of the issue of the threats of North Korea. You know, our system currently has 26 ground-based interceptors in Alaska and California, 18 Aegis missile defense ships, 13 Patriot battalions, and 5 ground-based radars, all supported by satellite-based systems and command and control systems. Now, the issue here is that this is deployed initially to respond to emerging threats, but it's an incomplete system. It's one we have not fully yet assembled, and it certainly is technology that is emerging. The more that we work with this, the more that we learn, the greater ingenuity that we have and the ability to respond to what are real threats to our country. As we all look to what Iran is doing and what North Korea is doing, we know that there is a real threat to our country, real threat to our allies, and real threat to our interests. So we have to preserve in this budget round our ability to fund the deployment of these systems, the maintenance, the upgrade, the research and development that will help us look to the future as to how do we protect our country and our allies. So this is a very important function. I really appreciate you bringing this to light and all of those participating.
Well, Congressman Aiken, I want to thank you again for your focus on this, because there is an information gap, I think, between our capability, what we're able to do, and what the American people know that we can do. So many times, when people talk about missile defense, they remember the past criticisms of that this is a system that would not work, it's an impossible task. Well, this is a system that not only works, it's deployed. Many people are not aware that we actually have missile defense systems that are deployed for the purposes of protecting the United States for the threat of North Korea. Again, as you and I were discussing, it's an incomplete system in that we have not fully deployed all of the system that's necessary to protect the United States. But again, this is a system that has not only been tested fully, responds to some of the threats that we have, but it's actually deployed. Now, it is just the first phase of a system. We have to continue our research, continue our the American ingenuity that is so great. You know, the missiles that you have behind you that that are able to intercept are so important, again, a technology that people said would not work. We have other technologies we need to explore, for example, the airborne laser. Being able to take high directed energy and actually apply them to some of the missiles that threaten us. That's the technology that's so important to pursue, because as we pursue research and development, as we pursue testing and find out the ways in which we can utilize these technologies to protect ourselves, we're going to perfect it, we're going to find the American ingenuity that we all know, and apply it in ways that protect our families, our communities, and our cities. Another area that's
important.
Could
I just reclaim for just a minute? We've only got about
Sure.
3 minutes. There's one thing that I promised you gentlemen I was going to toss in here, and this is something that people don't understand. I think we need to answer this question, that is, if somebody could smuggle a nuclear weapon into our country, why do we care so much about something on a missile? And the answer is that when a nuclear weapon is exploded high over a city, the amount of damage it does is hundreds of times what would happen if it were on the ground. And I think that's something people forget. It's a combination of the missile getting the altitude and no problems with security, and then all of a sudden you have this tremendous burst in the air over a city, just wreaks absolute havoc and kills millions of people. I want to make sure you hit that point.
Sure,
because people say, oh, this is a waste because somebody could just bring it in a suitcase. Not so simple. Please talk to that point.
Well, Congressman Aiken, I think that the real easy answer as to why we should have missile defense is because our adversaries are so interested in funding missiles.
Right.
I mean, they obviously see that missiles are a way that they put us at risk because they're investing so heavily in it, in research and technology, and we're seeing, you know, rogue nations, now North Korea and Iran, and their capabilities. The fact that they're reaching for these shows that we need to reach for the defense. One other area that I wanted to raise that I know that we need investment in is in the area of intelligence and our space capabilities, and that give us the eyes and ears and the ability to understand what some of the threats are, to be able to see them, to be able to respond. And again, with that, Congressman Aiken, I want to thank you so much for bringing this information to light for the public, because people need to know what's out there, what we're capable of, but also what's left for us to do.